We've all had those dreams where we're being chased, whether it was by a monster, serial killer, or just our old math teacher. And in those scenarios, we had no choice but to keep running endlessly until we woke up in a cold sweat. But what if you could control what happens next? Lucid dreaming is when the dreamer becomes self-aware in a dream and can even control their actions to a certain extent. This concept dates back thousands of years to ancient Hindu spiritual texts. Modern scientists have studied it, and even Aristotle wrote about it in 359 BC. It's thought that most people will experience lucid dreaming at least once in their lives. But did you know that there are actually verified techniques that allow you to control your dreams? Sounds pretty cool, right? As humans, we're capable of having incredibly rich, vivid, and imaginative dreams. Imagine a dolphin balancing an apple on its head. Even if you've never seen that before, did a picture pop into your mind? If yes, then what your brain just experienced was a phenomenon called mental synthesis, which is the driving mechanism behind imagination and an ability largely unique and distinctive to humans. Mental synthesis is what allows you to create complex situations and imagery that you've never experienced before. This extraordinary ability played a large part in the advance of human civilization, allowing us to visualize better shelters for protection, clever traps to capture food, and eventually, complex machinery and technology to improve our quality of life. It's also this ability that allows us to dream bizarre scenes at night, anywhere from giant squids to space monsters. There are usually 5 stages of sleep that we cycle through, with our most vivid dreams occurring during the 5th stage, called REM, which stands for rapid eye movement. During REM sleep, neurotransmitters are released onto the motor neurons so that they block the signals sent from the spinal cord to the muscles, thereby leading to paralysis. The generally accepted theory is that the body is doing this to prevent excessive movements during sleep that may lead to injury. Lucid dreaming might not be discussed very often, but it's actually a lot more common than we think. A German study in 2004 found that 82% of the psychology students they surveyed reported having had a lucid dream at least once in their life. There are also many reported cases of people deliberately training themselves to have multiple lucid dreams. Although the exact neuroscience behind dreaming is quite complex, scientists have found that generally during a dream, parts of the prefrontal cortex of the brain, which is largely responsible for higher processes, attention, and reasoning, become less active. However, in several studies, it has been found that various areas of the brain become more active during a lucid dream, and there can also be an increase in alpha waves, which normally occur when a person is awake with closed eyes. In recent years, scientists have been attempting to better understand lucid dreaming and conducting research on techniques that can induce lucid dreams. While most methods are either unreliable or not supported by science, there has recently been a verified technique that has shown promising results in the lab. In 2017, Dr. Denholm Aspey at the University of Adelaide performed a study where participants used 2 different methods to induce lucid dreaming. One was a reality check, where participants would get into the habit of regularly checking if they were awake. The second method was called mild, or mnemonic induction of lucid dreams, which involved the participants setting alarms to wake themselves up after 5 hours of sleep and reciting, "The next time I'm dreaming, I will remember that I'm dreaming," before going back to sleep. This experiment showed that while a single method alone was not very effective, using both methods simultaneously increased the chances of success significantly, with 53% of the participants lucid dreaming at least once during the trial period. In addition, there are several other methods which have shown to be effective for some people, such as keeping a record of the recurring elements in dreams and using those elements to help trigger a reality check. However, the mechanisms behind lucid dreaming are not well known, and even with practice, it is not always possible to have lucid dreams on demand, and the level of lucidity may vary as well as the length that one can experience it. But you might ask, why would we even want to control our dreams? Other than just sounding cool, does it actually have any real benefits? Lucid dreaming has actually been found to not only reduce stress and anxiety in certain patients, but also boost creativity and problem-solving skills. Lucid dreaming treatment, or LDT, used in pilot studies, has also been reported to help with symptoms of post-traumatic stress disorder, like treating nightmares, although its therapeutic potential is mostly unrecognized in the medical community. So, what do you think? Let us know in the comments below. Have you ever experienced lucid dreaming, and would you ever want to train yourself to do it? Thanks for watching! If you enjoyed this video, give us a thumbs up and leave a comment so that we can give you more content like this in the future. And don't forget to subscribe and click that bell icon below so you don't miss our future episodes. See you soon!